I request the third Deputy Prime Minister to follow.
By 7 a.m., mourners had started thronging Kololo ceremonial grounds for the funeral service of the late State Minister of Labour, Charles Engola, who was gunned down last week by his bodyguard. At around 10:45, the casket containing the deceased body was wheeled in by the military officers at Kololo ceremonial grounds. Speaking to the mourners, Joyce Aikoru, the wife of the fallen minister, described 2nd May as the darkest day of her life, the day her husband was killed.
Tuesday, 2nd of May, was the darkest part of my life. The morning began very well, a brighter morning, but little did I know the world was going to turn upside down. But I thank God. God had prepared me to face it.
She, however, noted that she chose to celebrate his life with hope that he died a very satisfied man with all the contributions he has done for the country.
He was called to serve in different capacities. I think he has made his contribution in this country. And I am well convinced he has gone to the Father very satisfied with life. He has not been complaining. Your Excellency, I would like to thank you for giving my husband to work in different areas, whether in politics, especially army. I would like to thank God that even during tough times, he never gave up.
Aikoru recounted the 23 years of their life, remembering Engola as a loving husband.
Stayed with him for the last 23 years. He came into my life and asked me to take care of the children because the nature of his work does not allow him to be always at home. We have seen the children married. We have seen the children working. Though others are still not working, just like you have seen the two little we have adopted 2 days before his demise. But I have hope because the message he has left in this book strengthens me.
Speaking on behalf of the children, Samuel Engola, the eldest son, remembered their father as a warrior and a very generous person who taught them to detest lies, witchcraft, and theft.
To detest lies, to detest theft, to detest witchcraft. Deep down in our hearts, as he kept on resounding that message to us, we indirectly learned to become truthful, to become honest, and to be prayerful.
It's at this point that, as children of the late, they unanimously agreed to forgive the late bodyguard Wilson Sabiti, who killed their father.
As our father lived with us, he taught us to forgive. He taught us to forgive. And he always said, whenever someone wrongs you, that's a debt for God to handle. Just forgive. It's at this juncture we want to take this opportunity. The children of the late, we acknowledge that the greater part of the family is doing something else to seek justice for him, but as the children of the late, we take this opportunity to forgive Private Sabiti.
After the special funeral service, the body of the slain minister was taken to his home in Chanja, Nakawa Division in Kampala. The body will depart for Oyam District at 8 a.m. on Thursday, where a council sitting will be held in his honor. Thereafter, it will be taken to the deceased home in Awanji Village, Icheme Sub-County in Oyam District. There will be a vigil at the deceased home on Friday. Slain Minister Engola will be laid to rest on Saturday in Icheme Sub-County, Oyam District. Report compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya for The News.